Musk thistle in the state of Oklahoma has been listed on the noxious weed list, so it is the landowner's responsibility to control that. There are three approved methods of controlling musk thistle in Oklahoma. One is mechanical, one is chemical, and one is biological. If we use the mechanical system as we mow, sometimes we have areas that we can't get into because of the roadside's too steep or the terrain's too rough or it's too rocky and we tear up machinery. Sometimes it's not cost effective to have people go out and physically cut the heads or to dig them. So we can turn to chemical control. And chemical control, once again, if we have a wetland and those musk thistles are located in that, we can't spray. Or if we're around a stream bed or a pond, we can't spray. So then we rely on our biological control, which is the musk thistle head weevil. Now the musk thistle head weevil, Oklahoma Cooperative Extension Service, released its first head weevils in eastern Oklahoma in 1991. And since that point, as the population grew, we've had weevil roundups each year to relocate the weevils. In northern Oklahoma, we usually see our weevils emerge and start laying eggs around the 9th or the 10th of May. Each one of these weevils will have approximately 100 eggs. And once the female lays her eggs this year, she will die. As people drive down the highway and they see musk thistle in this stage, it's a very pretty, very showy purple flower. Doesn't matter where it grows, rangeland, forage land, in bar ditches, roadsides, in municipalities. If it's not controlled, each one of those flowers have approximately 10,000 seeds, and each one of those seeds are viable in the soil for up to 9 years. So we need to be able to biological control. The head weevil works quietly, loves beautiful weather, it works in the rain. We have to physically come out and look at the plant itself to be able to know that we have head weevil and then to assess the damage that that weevil has done upon that plant. Once we know that we have our head weevils, if we didn't see head weevils, we can still identify that head weevils has been here by looking at the stem itself or the heads to see if there's been any eggs that have been lain by the head weevil. We need to remember that the head weevil has 100 eggs that it can lay. Those eggs hatch in about 6 to 8 days, and then the larvae will feed on the flower for 25 to 30 days, and then it pupates, and after it pupates, within 3 to 4 weeks, it will emerge as an adult head weevil looking for a place to overwinter till next year. The ones that hatch this year will not lay eggs till next spring. If we're going to collect weevil, the one thing that we need to understand is the musk thistle head weevil, he'll fold up his legs and he'll just fall over, so we have to be very careful. We need to make sure that we haven't had cattle walk through the area beforehand, because as they touch the plant, the weevil will fall off. When we get ready to collect the musk thistle head weevil to relocate it, we're going to get our sweep net and a stick, and we will place the sweep net underneath the head of the musk thistle plant. Gently bend the flowering part over with your stick and tap that into the net. As you do that, the musk thistle head weevil itself will fold its legs up and fall into the sweep net. And we're going to do that multiple times. The more you do that, the more weevils that you will collect. Try not to miss a head, but try not to hit the plants to knock them off before you get your sweep net underneath them. Once we get those into the sweep net, then we can take them back to a location spot. Once again, we're going to try to move about 500 of those to a new location. Remember to put them in some type of cardboard cup, not plastic. Keep them cool before we transport, while transporting, and get them released as soon as possible. And remember, we need to understand what our state law is about head weevils themselves. Can we move them or can we not? To recap, the musk thistle plant is a bright, showy plant. The flower can produce up to 10,000 seeds that are viable in the soil for up to 9 years. For more information on controlling musk thistle, go to factsheet.okstate.edu.